In this video, we want to explain how to write and execute our own SQL statements using KNIME database nodes. If you know your way around SQL and want to create or build your own custom queries, the KNIME database extension includes a set of nodes for this. For example, the DB query with a script editor for your own SQL script, the DB SQL executor for executing non-select statements directly on the database, the DB query reader for executing SQL statements that return data on the database and provide the results in a KNIME data table, and the parameterized DB query reader for executing SQL queries with a KNIME data table as the lookup table. Let's have a look at an example workflow. In this workflow, we use contract data from the web activity table on this H2 database and create a categorical income column, delete data related to the private investment product, select the two most popular products among customers with at least two contracts, and finally, filter the contract data to these two products and read the data into a KNIME data table. Let's start by creating a new column called Income Category. The DB Query node allows us to customize the SQL query in its DB data input port. We can see this query, in this case, a simple select statement, in its configuration dialog here in the script editor. During execution, this table placeholder will be wrapped by our own SQL statement, and the wrapped query will be provided in the node's output. We write the query to create the income categories and click this Evaluate button to check if it's correct. We click OK and execute the node. Notice that if you apply your custom query directly after accessing the database table like we do here, you can also do this in the script editor embedded in the configuration dialog of the DB table selector node. Check custom query and then write the query in the editor that activates. Doing this means you can then skip the DB query node at this point. Next, let's start a new branch to create a lookup table for filtering. We start by deleting all data for the private investment product. This means we'll execute a delete statement that doesn't return any data, and we'll do this with the DB SQL executor node. The configuration dialog looks similar to the DB query node, and we write the statement here in the script editor. If we enable this support multiple SQL statements option here, we can even execute multiple non-select statements, such as drop and insert, by this one node, using the separator defined here. All data with product equal to private investment is now deleted in the database table. Let's now build the final lookup table. We need the lookup table as a KNIME data table, so we use the DB query reader node that executes the query on the database and provides the result in its data table output. We open the configuration dialog and write the query there. The data are now filtered by this WHERE clause. We click OK and check the output. This table shows two products, gold investment and P plus B investment. We now have our lookup table handy. Finally, we want to filter the web activity database table by taking only data related to the products in our lookup table. We can do this with the parameterized DB query reader node. This node allows you to execute a given SQL query repeatedly, each time with different parameter values, that is, column values in the lookup table. This node takes two inputs, a KNIME data table and a DB data port. It loops over the input KNIME data table, the lookup table, and parameterizes the input SQL query using values in it. Let's open the configuration dialog and build this query. Here you can see that, in addition to the database column list panel, there is also a column list panel that lists available columns in the lookup table. We want to select all data from the input database table, where the product also appears in the lookup table. So, we write a WHERE clause here and enter products, which is the column in the database table, is equal to products indicated by dollar sign characters, which is the corresponding column in the lookup table. If we check this Append Input Columns option, the columns from the lookup table in the SQL query will be added to the output. We can further customize this option by selecting Include Empty Results, which also adds those entries from the lookup table that didn't match any value in the database table. Retain All Columns will append all columns in the lookup table, even if they're not used in the SQL query. If the Fail on Error option is checked, the node will fail if any errors occur during execution. Otherwise, it will continue executing and all errors will be collected and presented in the node's output. We open the top output and we can see that only data related to the two products in the lookup table are returned. In this video, we've explained how to write custom SQL statements using KNIME database nodes. We've shown how to complement the DB nodes that have a visual user interface with the DB nodes that include a script editor.